Up some big developments out of Libya just within the last hour or so, where government officials have declared a ceasefire. This move coming one day after the UN authorized a no-fly zone and other necessary measures. Several countries are preparing a military response. Here's the British Prime Minister David Cameron addressing Parliament in the UK this morning.
Our consistent approach has been to isolate the Qaddafi regime, deprive it of money, shrink its power, and ensure that anyone responsible for abuses in Libya will be held to account. I also told this House that I believe contingency planning should be done for different scenarios, including involving military assets.
Gordon Johndroe is a former National Security Council spokesman under President George W. Bush. Good morning, Gordon. Nice to see you. So what do you make of the ceasefire announcement?
I think Qaddafi is playing for time. He's watched the international community sit on the sidelines, the United States sit on the sidelines for the last 31 days. And I think that he thinks that if he puts a ceasefire in place, that he can hold off any military action, and we'll just have to see.
And we should mention that this is really not the first ceasefire that's been called. There have been previous ceasefires that were announced in order to give the rebels a chance to surrender, right?
Right, exactly. And of course, they did not want to surrender, and they've been holding out hope for support from the United States, from Arab countries, and from other members of NATO. And hopefully they will get it soon.
Okay, so if Qaddafi is just trying to buy some more time, now we know of this UN resolution which calls for all necessary measures to be taken. How do you measure the resolve of the international community? What are we talking about here?
Well, I don't think we'll see ground forces go into Libya, but I think what we'll see is airstrikes, not just to have a no-fly zone, but hopefully against some of Qaddafi's tank columns and his artillery and his troops on the ground, so that the rebels can try and retake some of the territory that they recently had. It's unfortunate that this resolution didn't come sooner in order to help the rebels out.
What do you think would be the first step? I mean, and how quickly would we see it? I mean, there's been this announcement of a ceasefire. We don't have any reaction really from the United States or from Great Britain or France, for that matter. But how long do you think Qaddafi buys with this ceasefire until we start seeing some kind of military action take place?
Yeah, well, his whole point in doing this is that once the U.S. and Europeans and Arabs go in with military strikes, he's going to say that we violated the ceasefire, you know, that he put a ceasefire in place trying to act in good faith with the U.N. resolution, and then we violated it. So I hope it's not too much longer that we see military action from Western and Arab powers, but it's hard to see. They've probably got to be rethinking their position now with this ceasefire announcement.
Gordon, do you think that the U.S. is kicking itself for waiting so long to get to this point?
A little bit. I mean, look, the Japanese earthquake was a distraction, but this Libyan uprising started before the Japanese earthquake. I say it was a distraction. It was a tragedy that took away the focus of the White House from Libya, rightfully, and focusing on the issues in Japan. But, you know, they also had to remain focused on helping the people of Libya who are trying to get rid of their dictator for the last 40 years.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I just have time for one more question quickly. Any acceptable end to this where Qaddafi remains in power?
No, I don't think so. You know, President Obama called him to leave, that Qaddafi has to go. Then President Obama didn't take a whole lot of action until the UN vote last night. Right. He's got to follow through on his commitment to see Qaddafi out the door.